pretty loud. Patrice Bergeron starts it off against Henrik Sedin, and we are underway with game one. 69 shots, and not one has gone in. Played on back. This one challenged free and onside. Kessler gave it on across. Defeated, but scores!
The Bruins bench was yelling at Marchand to go because it was Henrik Sedin, a forward in a one-on-one situation. Henrik played it well.
Rattled on by Ferentz. Kept alive, though, by Sammy Salo. Pitched around in front. Oh, and it hurts up, and Rossi scores! On Horton, and then Lucic behind. There had been some alteration in the lines here early after that power play. Here's a shot that was blocked by Luongo. But now this is the big line back together again. Krejci lays it back. Boychuk, a shot and a save. Luongo, rebound. They score! Out of an Edmonton scramble. It is Lucic, and the game is tied.
The creativity of David Krejci makes this all happen, Edzo.
They've had some good looks.
Chara dropped it off, carried on by Ryder. Ryder filtered it through neatly, spiked away from Recchi, covered by Ryder, and swept across to Chara. Chara with Rister, score! And the Bruins get a power play goal and break the tie.
It's all about the entry, Edzo, and it's a good job by Michael Ryder gaining entry.
Lucic able to play it there. Drubbed it on back, Chara handcuffed by that. It came along to Henrik Sedin, who takes it to the outside and lobs it on back to Edler. Shovel shot, it is bedside of the net, score! The Bruins win, they get home ice. If the Canucks win a stranglehold, the Bruins would have to win four of the next five, if it even went that far. And here's Burrows moving in, fakes the drive, and around behind he's chased the loose puck, he scores! Raymond and Beverly go for it. Raymond prevailed on that. But a stick is broken. It's carried back in to the outside. A shot! And getting a piece of that was Luongo on the try from Krejci. Score! Just a toss! And it becomes the first one. Shot by Ferentz is deflected up high. Beverly was reaching for that one. Given back to Chara by Recchi. On to Ferentz. Ferentz connects with Ryder. Two Bruins near the net. Ryder found one to the outside. Thrown in front. Beverly scores! Erhoff able to advance it ahead. Carried on by Daniel Sedin. Lost it. Poked away by Marchand. Dances to the outside. Takes his own pass. Marchand along in front. Flying all over in the last 4:20 of the second period.
What a great shift there for Sean Thornton.
Brought on by Ryder. Ryder and Sean guided out another chance. Score! Krejci!
See where the league falls on that.
Every hockey fan in Boston will have their ears peeled. Him. LaPierre swept one all the way to the back. A little over 6 minutes to go as Albert pitched it behind. LaPierre with it there. Played to the outside side of the net. Score! The first goal of the game is collected by Yannick Hansen. The first goal for the Canucks, and they cut the lead to four with 6:07 to go.
What a nice pass by Rafi Torres.
Not entirely because, here comes a two-on-one, might be a three. But ahead with it, Bergeron led it across, and a stiff pass was off of Marchand. Out in front, score! Recchi! Annoyed for reasons that are probably obvious by the way we've documented the game. Restless because of past experiences in difficult situations and how things go. This is another goal scored by Kelly. Make it seven.
Well, we know both teams do a lot of video work, and you wonder.
Translate that, Pierre.
He's not rubbing it in. He doesn't want to send any more messages. Message has been sent.
We noticed Guy Boucher did that in the last round against Boston. Score, Michael Ryder. Seems great for 17,000 and change here in Boston. And flopped right back in.
Well, last chance there after the shot on goal. Dennis Seidenberg collided with Tim Thomas. He was out of his net for a couple of seconds.
Oh, here's a chance for Peverly! Score! On back to Sammy Salo, chipped on across, and reading this is Sagan. Sagan got there, fed it ahead. Ryder walks it into the zone. Here's Ryder shooting. He scores! Sedin had emerged and was about to take a pass, but Jara was able to get it and keep play alive. Henrik Sedin, close quarters, it's jabbed in front, score! Marchand! In the regular season, maybe we'll see each other in the final. Sure enough. Lucic nicely rags free. Sent along by Torres, onto the back, walked across by BX, and a shot, deflected wide, rebound! Score! Reverse back through traffic by Marchand, dumped behind now for Seidenberg. Scaled on out to center, and that one kicked aside, but it's brought right back on by Marchand, and a shot. He scores! BX steps to that one. Boychuk takes it and blasts it back in. Walk back ahead by Peverly. Drop back off. Lucic a shot. He scores! Fed to the back and held there carefully by Ferentz, spun over to Michael Ryder, filtered back to Ferentz, fires, goal!
Gotta get him out of there.
In the Canucks' heads.
Both these teams have talked about playing whistle to whistle. You continue to do that, I think a referee's got to take control of the game. You start giving guys twos and tens. First one out.
Another goal on the shot from the point by Caverly. Early stages, third period. 55 seconds of power play time remaining to the Canucks. As this one hopped over for Henrik Sedin. Henrik Sedin holds it up, drifts, and shoots. He scores! Henrik Sedin, with his first point of the series, has gotten his team a power play goal. Chara drive, and the save, Schneider. Rebound, side of the net. Oh, and Schneider robbed of Recchi. He's able to come up with it, though, and hand back to Caverly. Then Recchi again. Threw one across. Score! Krejci!
Being aggressive, being out of his net. I mean, the best way to answer that would have been, I got my own issues. We're looking forward to game six. End of story.
Yeah.
No need to.
That is a goal by LaPierre, and it is 5-2 with 2:26 to go.
Nice play by Daniel Sedin. He just put this on a tee for Maxime LaPierre.
Offensive zone faceoff is won by the Bruins. Twirling to the outside is Marchand. Some weaving in front of Luongo, and a feed in front. They score! A lot of traffic in front, and Patrice Bergeron has gotten the first goal of the game.
And Eddie, this is a double whammy because it's against the Sedins and Burrows.
Marchand doubled back. Bieksa in the way. Send it back to Seidenberg. A shot! Save Luongo! Rebound! It bounces all around. Reaching Luongo, but a wraparound attempt by Marchand! He scores! Marchand! And it's 2-0.
Eddie, this is all off a bad change by Vancouver. Allowed Michael Ryder easy access into the zone. You're not going to get many more opportunities with the power play and no Chara on the ice. Remember that, Chara in the box.
Slugged along, and a tough play for Erhoff to make as it careens to Bergeron, who moves in. Bergeron protects, and down to the ice he goes. The puck wound up going into the net. It's 3-0. A shorthanded goal for Bergeron. And he does. Henrik Sedin lobbed it on out. Burrows kicked it on back. The net still empty. Dropping back as BX has a goalie. Marchand the shot. He scores! Marchand! Second goal of the night. Fourth for the Bruins. Hansen gave it across with 15 to go. Despite that adversity, they followed their coach to the high road. And the high road is the road to the cup. No icing. For the first time in 39 years, the Boston Bruins have won the Stanley Cup. And they pour on to celebrate with Tim Thomas, their heroic goaltender. Midway in the playoffs, any success I have ever had has come from working hard. And here's a little bit more with the Conn Smythe Trophy. 39 different players have had it. Tim Thomas becomes the 15th time that it has been taken by a goaltender. He comes forward to receive the cup, and this will undoubtedly be the highest that it's ever been held. Who will be the first to receive it from Chara?
Gotta be Mark Recchi.